Hello students, welcome to the class on editorial decode, and in this class I will be decoding our national security mismanagement written by Happimon Jacob. Now from examination point of view, this will help you in general studies mains examination paper 2 and paper 3. Plus this is important for political science and public administration optional students. Now what is this editorial about? This editorial is about the approach that the Indian government is following with respect to national security. This editorial is about how the approach of centralization is actually antithetical to the welfare and development of internal security infrastructure. This editorial is also about how we need to tinker with and how we need to strengthen internal security infrastructure. Now, in order to understand this editorial, first of all, we need to understand the scope and the nature of the national security. Now, as far as national security is concerned, it is having quite encompassive, quite holistic, and quite wide scope. Now, how encompassive it is? Now, when it comes to national security has to do with the defense setup in India. It has to do with the police establishments. It has to do with the internal security. It has to do with the intelligence agencies. It has to do with the coordination between the central government and the state government. And it has to do with the research and the development that currently we are doing in the domain of the national security. It has to do with the indigenous production of the defense products and the gadgetry. It has to do with how much is our dependency with respect to the defense setup onto the foreign powers. Now, as far as India is concerned, we have introduced a lot of energy in all these domains. We have introduced energy in the defense establishment. But till date, our dependency on the import for the defense gadgetry and for the defense products is still 70%. Only 30% of the indigenous production is done by us. So we are just producing 30% of our requirement, and this is something that is a big area of concern for India. And the next aspect of the internal security is the intelligence collection. Now when it comes to intelligence collection, we have got research and analysis wing, we have got IB, intelligence bureau. Now both these organizations are actually based on the structure of bureaucracy. There is a hierarchical layering on the basis of which these organizations work. Now, because the functioning is based on bureaucracy, there is a very less bottom to up communication. But when it comes to intelligence collection, your bottom hierarchies should be really strengthened. Your bottom hierarchies should have personals that are oozing out with energy to collect the intelligence. Then another aspect of the intelligence collection is that these days the intelligence collection, it has more to do with the cyber thing. And this is one area in which India has actually not performed well. Then another area of the national security in which India needs to improve a lot is the coordination between all these agencies and specializing this domain of national security. Now, since this government has taken over the reins, this government has actually generalized this entire domain of national security. We are aberrating from, we are veering away from the specialization which this domain requires. Now, this author, Hapimon Jacob, he has told about how the National Security Council, it is lying in a state of moribund. How National Security Advisory Board and National Security Council are not performing the work for which they were set up during Atal Bihari Vajpayee era. Now both these institutions should be reinvigorated. They need to create, there is a requirement of strengthening the synergy between both these institutions. Then apart from that, we also need to tinker with the hierarchies and the coordination and the cooperation between the paramilitary and the military and the police. Like in the police, in the army, we need to create chief of defense staff post. Now creating this post will be like creating a bigger avenue for coordination. Abhi kya hai? Air Force, Navy aur Army ke beech mein coordination nahi hai. Coordination kyun nahi hai? Kyunki unko unified guide karne wala koi post nahi establish kiya gaya. जब तक आप एक यूनिफाइड पोस्ट एस्टैब्लिश नहीं करोगे तो उनका आपस में एट्रिशन होता रहेगा. अगर आपको उनका आपस में एट्रिशन को रोकना है, डिसकोऑर्डिनेशन को रोकना है, मिसमैनेजमेंट को रोकना है और कोऑर्डिनेशन को इन्फ्यूज करना है, आपको एक पोस्ट क्रिएट करना पड़ेगा चीफ ऑफ डिफेंस स्टाफ का. ये जो पोस्ट है चीफ ऑफ डिफेंस स्टाफ का, इट विल एक्चुअली एनहांस द कोऑर्डिनेशन बिटवीन Army, Navy and Air Force. And India also needs to work in the domain of intelligence collection. And one such institution that India had set up in the past is National Intelligence Grid. Now again we need to infuse energy into it. And India also needs to work on data encryption policy. India also needs to work on cyber policy. India also needs to work on how India should be tackling the problem of left-wing extremism. Now all these areas, they should be worked in tandem. Because if we will be not working in tandem in all these areas, the synergy that is required to tackle the challenges and the problems and the issue areas of the defense sector will not work out. So this was all for the intro. Leakcode, you can subscribe to this channel. Name of channel is EIS Mentors. You can contact me at 845-94-0000 in case you are interested in buying the video classes on entire civil services preparation. And in order to view the information of the class that we are offering, please visit our websites eiasmentors.com and brainiki.com. And in case you like this video, do click on the like button, do share and comment on this video. So this was all for the day. Bye-bye, take care, have a nice, nice day.